Hi, if you want to have the same video for both HLS streaming and DASH streaming, then this video is for you. Because in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use same segments or video to serve both HLS and DASH. I'll be using Shaka Packager to show the procedure. And first of all, I'll have to install Shaka Packager on my computer, then use it from terminal to generate HLS and master playlist with the pre-encoded video. Okay, let's dive into that. First of all, here on my XAMPP's HDoc folder on my server, I have created a folder named HLS and put a MP4 file named input.mp4, which will be used as an input for this example. And now I'll go to my browser and we'll go to this link for Shaka Packager open source project from Google. Here, if I scroll down gradually, I'll see that getting Shaka Packager section where get pre-built binaries from release. I have to click on this one, and in the release page, I'll download the packager win.exe file from here to work on my Windows machine. Okay, so I'm downloading this one and I'll save it on my C drive. And we'll name it as packager.exe. I'm creating a folder here, packager, a folder named packager, and putting my packager.exe file on the folder. So now I have to add the paths to my environment variable. Edit the system environment variable option, going to environment variable, and on the path I'll be adding the path for Shaka Packager, which is this one. Packager. Copying the path. And placing it on the environment variable. And after okaying that, now I'll go to my server directory again. On my HLS folder, here I have sample video named input.mp4. Here, this is the command I'll be using to package the input video to HLS and DASH playlist. So here, for 360p and 480p and 780p video, which will be different, I've used the same input. The input is input.mp4. If you transcode the 480p video and 720p video and 1080p video with MPEG and have separate video file, of course you will have separate video file, then the mapping will be here. The 1080p input file will be, the name of 1080p input file will be placed here, and vice versa in the similar way. So I am prepared this command with a single video for all type of quality, and will copy this and put on my terminal to see if it works or not. Okay, I'm opening my terminal here. And after pasting the command, I can see that packaging is completed. The time is very short because Shaka Packager only does the packaging, it does not transcode or re-encode the video. So if I go to the directory now, first of all I had only one file named input.mp4. Now we have a few segments. I have few segments and m3bit file and mpd file for the input. So here, as you can see, this audio.mp4 is used by both HLS and DASH. You don't need to duplicate the processed video for HLS and DASH separately. This will give you more space on the hard disk of the server, I guess. Okay, now to test this, I'll open my browser and try to access the main master playlist file from browser. for both HLS and DASH. This one is for HLS and this one is for DASH. H264.mpd, always for DASH. This is an XML file and this is basically an hashtag based playlist file. So we'll access both file from browser with an extension for HLS and DASH player to see if we can play the video. So the input is localhost / HLS. Here we have all the files. So first of all, I will try to access the h264.mpd, which is basically a XML based MPD file for DASH. And
I'm asking you again, where were you on Wednesday, February 14th, 2018?
The video is being played.
I have been detained for over
and again, if I go back and try to access the h264_master.mt8, then I'll see that again the video is being played.
I'm asking you again, where were you on Wednesday, February 14th, 2018?
Both master playlist file.
I have been detained for over 4 hours.
And MPD file are using the same media, which is these files. So this is how HLS and DASH works together. Saves a lot of space when you have a huge OTT server. You need both DASH and HLS depending on the requirement. You can't do this. Okay, if you have learned anything and can have your problem solved from this video, then I'm successful making this video. And if you have any question or any suggestion for me or anything like that, feel free to comment and let me know what you think about this video. So until next time, happy coding.